They've got Jean-Louis. Kidnapped.
You know that kid's probably like in his 60s now?
Probably. He's probably dead.
People don't live after they've existed in movies in the 60s anymore.
I mean, that kid, he had a hard life after.
Let's suppose about
the success of Jean-Louis, the character of Jean-Louis went to his head and...
Well, he got to call Audrey Hepburn Auntie, Auntie Reggie or whatever.
Yeah,
I mean,
after that,
really her aunt, technically. Mm-hmm.
Things just fell apart, fell right into drugs, swept up in it.
All those kooky child actors.
Yeah, no!
Darn it.
So before, when we were chitty-chatting off camera, you were saying that you had a good Cary Grant story.
Well, and my story is this. It's not a story. It's actually truth, but I find it really interesting that this film, in the careers of Audrey Hepburn and Cary Grant, you know, it was really the end of the golden era of Hollywood. And so they're both aging. Yeah, aging at 33 for Audrey Hepburn. But,
yeah.
You know, she already made all of her classics before this.
And he's at 59.
He completely had already made all of his. And this was the only time they worked together. So he was almost 30 years older than her. Okay. All right. So he was freaking out. But this says something to his character. He went to Universal and he said, supposedly, you know, I don't want to come off as lecherous. So to the screenwriter, he said, I'll only do this film if you make my part not be the one, you know, initiating the romantic advances. If it's on her, then it'll be okay. I won't look like a creep.
Okay? That was smart of him.
It was, and very classy, I think, you know?
Yeah.
And so, but for Audrey Hepburn, you know, think about all of her films. You know, you've got, you know, Eliza, the character of Eliza Doolittle. And
Sabrina.
You know, stuff. Sabrina, exactly.
The Nun.
Her other classics, where she's always having this, like, father figure, mentor, I'm the man, I'm going to tell you how it is, blah, blah, blah. But in this one, she's, like, coming on to him. She's flirting.
Yeah,
she wants him. He doesn't want her. It's totally empowering for her. It's huge. It's huge.
She's, like, trying to kiss him, and he's on the phone. He's like, get out of here, Audrey Hepburn. I'm like, I don't buy it.
He's like, stop it. But then he's like, oh, wait, why are you stopping? Do you remember that scene? It's so funny.
That's cool.
Yeah.
He just seems like a nice guy, and it's nice to hear that backstory that he actually was like, no.
He actually was a really nice guy, I think, you know?
Or maybe he was just trying to put up a smokescreen.
Maybe he just wanted her.
Maybe he just wanted her. You know, how could you not?
I know, she's so beautiful in this film. Mm-hmm. And the clothes, can we just talk about that for 2 seconds?
Yeah.
Oh,
go
my
for it.
God. Like, even if you hate the movie, every single outfit. Okay, here she is. She lost her whole wardrobe.
She's like,
it was stolen.
I only have what's in this suitcase.
But the suitcase is filled with this
beautiful
red
suitcase. Like
the most incredible French Givenchy outfits in the world.
Beautiful black party dress.
Oh my God, they're so beautiful. I can't stop looking at the clothes.
Well, here's to Cary Grant.
Here's to him.
And to Audrey's clothes.
Okay.
Lauren will have her glass of water to them.
I'm pretending like it's a scotch, because that's what the man would have wanted.
highball.
Yeah, oh, man. Oh, this will work. When we come back, we'll have Indie Insight with Dirk Norris, and we'll have more Pulp Film Lab, so stick around.
New Mexico film series Breaking Bad has which successful spin-off show? Tuco's Revenge, Say My Name, Tough Love, or Better Call Saul?